I'm Vincent Martinez of fashionado.net, and I'm at the Imagine Music Festival 2018, sitting with Leah Culver and John Wilkes. We just got off set.
Yay!
With these two killers. So I should ask how you feel, but I mean, I was on stage with you. I mean, I can see it. And let me just start by saying, first of all, congratulations. But my videographer was pointing out something interesting. You realize that everybody on stage, including us, we were dancing.
I did.
We were so, I don't know if you noticed
really?
It, because you were busy doing this.
Yeah.
You were busy doing this and running around and doing but everybody from us, your mom, all the stage help, everybody was dancing. So congrats to both of you.
Thank you.
That's the goal.
That's the goal.
That's always the goal.
Yeah. So do you get asked all the time, like right after a performance, oh, how does it feel? I mean, I feel that's kind of a trite, kind of cliche question, but I'm sure it's different for everybody. I mean, the energy must just be through the roof right now for you.
Yeah, I think it was a really great one because right as we were doing sound check, we had this really scary thing happen with the CDJs, which made me very nervous to do it.
Oh.
But it went well.
Okay.
It went really well.
So John, you are not just a drummer. I mean, you are such a badass drummer, but you're also working with Leah the last couple of years or so, stage manager and just everything. I mean, everything. What do you do?
Well, she comes up with these incredible ideas. Like last year, she was like, "I want a kids choir." And I was like, "Well, I think we can make that happen." So I started calling around to children's choirs in Atlanta, and I found one, and we did that last year. And then
I remember.
This year, I was like, you know what? Let's be a little more punk rock. So we started talking about it. I was like, let's get a guitar player. Let's have like a solo violin player, maybe some like electronic drums, like kind of like Slipknot almost, you know? And then me doing my thing.
Yeah.
And I was like, let's do it that way and like make it feel like a band almost the whole time.
Yeah. And they were going the whole, you went the whole time.
Yeah, I went the whole time.
You did. Yeah. Well, there are many things that I really love about you. Well, thank you. You're welcome, but thank you.
Aww.
I mean, your energy is just incredible, but you are really, really about entertainment, where some DJs, I mean, you know, it's fine. That's what they do. They're up there the entire time. They're doing this thing, but you are doing all of that, and you're jumping off stage. You're going around to the front. You're singing. Now you're playing drums. I mean, you've got a full-scale production. No one else does this, Leah. I'm not kidding. No one else does this.
The crowd deserves it. The crowd deserves a show like that. I don't know why there aren't more people doing it, but I respect everyone who doesn't do it just as much as the guys that come up and do it with us, you know?
Yeah.
Doing the drums was really cool because that song is so slow, and I'm not used to it being so slow, but... It worked.
And you looked really good too on there, by the way. And I have to also really say that, and I mean, huge, you know, kudos to both of you because when I said how fun your stage set is and everyone's dancing, you also, it's a party. You let everybody up there where, again, we try to come up during some other big DJs. They've got, what do you call it, blackout. You can't go up there.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't even go up the ramp to go backstage. You're so not like that, and I hope it's...
You want a family up there. It is family up there.
Well, literally, because your mom's up there.
My mom's up there, so everyone's family to my mom.
You know, we are mom's fan club. I mean, she's your biggest fan, of course.
I'm her biggest fan.
So let's talk a little bit, though, about music, because you've had a lot going on. I mean, when we first met, really the three of us, you were playing during the day. And if you remember, I said, you need to be at night. This is BS. You need to be at night.
That was the first year, right?
The first year.
Yep.
And here you are. I mean, you're at sunset and it's dark. You've completely captivated a huge crowd. But your music has also grown and evolved. I mean, is it Get Going? Is that your latest?
Get Going was the last one that I put out, but I'm sitting on so much new music, and I got to play a lot of it, and a lot of it is just like completely like so new that I'm like, do I know the words? Let's just go out and do it. And that's what we did, especially War. I don't know if you could tell, but yeah, she has enough songs
for about 5 or 6 albums.
That's good, right? That's fabulous.
Every day she's doing new songs. Like you played the Fire Ant.
Fire Ants. I opened up with Fire Ants, essentially.
She built that from nothing. Yeah. Like, produced the entire thing.
Yeah.
Wow. Which is so dope. Like, she played it for me. She's like, should we put it in the set? I'm like, yes. Like, it's so dope. Yeah. Like, it's like, Fire Ants.
Thank you. Yeah, Fire Ants.
That sounded like Fire Ants, but like this, you know?
Well, and then your dancers came out also like ants, too.
So cool,
That was the coolest thing. I didn't get to, when I saw them, I didn't even realize they were up there with me until I like turned around and I was like, they're so sick. They look so sick. Did you see like the fake blood on them, the foxes?
Yes.
I was like, rad.
So do you enjoy singing as much as you do writing music and performing, or is it all just one big happy family for you?
I think it's all different beasts. Like my production level this year has like grown massively after going to Icon Collective.
Yeah.
I graduated 6 months ago and it was the best decision I ever made. If you're interested in music production, you absolutely should go to Icon Collective. It's where Jaws went, Nightmare, Slander.
And where is this?
I think he did.
Is this here in Atlanta or
no,
somewhere?
It's in Los Angeles.
Los Angeles,
But
to answer your question, singing is, it's been my happy place since I was little.
Yeah.
Like, I've been singing around since I was 3. Writing music, like lyrics, since I could write, you know. And then played guitar and drums 13, 14, 15. I was really, really highly influenced by Hayley Williams. If you can't like tell by all the headbanging, I'm still so inspired by her. But I think my favorite is performing, and I get a different high in the studio. Different.
You do it very naturally. I mean, I'm a fly on the wall when I'm on stage with you, and I notice everything. And I see your facial expressions. I see your body language. I mean, you are so in tune with what you are doing. It's almost like everything around you is not really there. It's all about what you're delivering to your audience.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what it seems like.
We like to keep it nice and free, though. We set a parameter for the live.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, we're gonna have this person come out. We're gonna have this musician come out. We're gonna have the dancers come out freely whenever they feel like
it. Yeah, it's very free
this
year.
But we keep it free on purpose so that when we present it to the audience, it feels real.
Your biggest fan, as we identified, is Mom.
Mom.
Your biggest fan said something to me backstage. She said, this is the year. This is the year. What does that mean? Tell us, what does that mean, this is the year?
I mean,
what's going on?
Mom always thinks it's the year because she's like, Mom, you know? But I think she means like, just I just have so much music.
Yeah.
And I'm finally gonna start releasing it. And it's just like the right collabs are already in place, the right releases with, it probably is the year.
Can you speak about any of those collaborations, or are they top secret? Look at John, I think. No one's listening right now, it's okay.
I don't know yet. But
keep us in suspense, that's okay.
Coming.
So let's talk about one other thing, because you had a friend, I think a special guest. I was hoping a special guest might pop in here somewhere. Do you see him around?
Well, hang on a second.
Bring him over, come on, bring him over.
Are we talking about Toyla Carter?
Do you hear that?
Toyla! You know, he's amazing. He's really, really amazing. He's like one of the best vocalists I've ever heard.
So that was him singing, because the Killers.
He sang over the Killers today. His stuff is dope.
Over here.
Yeah. Yeah. There he comes. Yes.
It's Toyla.
Take a seat real quick.
Are you screaming at me?
Well, you were screaming at everybody.
Was I?
Well, singing and screaming.
I was trying to just
in the
give
best
it
way.
Everything.
You gave it all and you were amazing.
I gave it
so
all.
Tell everybody who this is.
This is Tyler Carter from the band Issues.
Hi.
And he was our surprise guest this year.
Oh, yeah, and I was a surprise. I was surprised.
Yeah, it was really last second.
You know, this is my first EDM festival, or EDM concert in general, and it's a whole new world for me. I come from a metal world, So coming into your world?
They both do, yeah.
Oh my God. Well, so you cross worlds. You got it all figured out. I'm just like stepping out of my front yard, you know what I mean? Like I'm figuring.
Well, it worked really well. And I heard the vocals, and you know, before I saw you, because where I was standing, I couldn't see you out front. And I thought, okay, that is not Leah. I mean, there's no way that's you on the microphone. So that was you.
Yeah. Incredible.
I hope it sounded okay. I heard the monitors for a bit, but you know, between the whiskey and the not having in-ears.
You nailed it. It was amazing. It was nuts.
Go with what your guts like.
I mean, it was better than okay. Did you see the crowd?
The crowd was lit.
Yeah.
And he was doing kicks like Freddie Mercury up there, man.
Yeah.
There's pictures of it.
Want to do a kick now? Well, we got video of that, too.
Part of me was living in the crowd while I was on stage. Because I was like, oh, my God, I want to be camping with all y'all right now.
Yeah.
It was taking me back to my childhood. I would go to, like, festivals and campgrounds and stuff with my grandfather. But I've never done that as an adult. I've never gone to festivals or gone to like campgrounds and done all this exciting shit. So I'm like, I was putting myself out there for a minute.
Yeah,
that's awesome. So, well, I just wanted to introduce you guys.
Thank you. Thank you to all of you. Absolutely. Thank you. Positively. Yeah.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
Dude, you're the best. I was so honored to have you. I'm such a fan.
Okay, he's
Tyler, everybody.
How adorable is he too, though? I mean,
the best.
Yeah. So, you guys, before we wrap this up, come on. Is there anything you want to leave us with? You want to talk about? You want to shout out?
Yeah.
Yeah. Go. Yeah. You listen.
Okay.
There's no time limit here. So just, it's all yours, baby. Come on.
I'm working on so much new music, and I'm working on two EPs that I'm about to bring out into the world somehow, and we're gonna be doing a lot more live shit together, stuff together.
You can say shit.
Shit.
I mean, it's not an EDM concert. Actually, that's not even the word. I mean, everyone says the F word. So it's like, it's not an EDM festival if you don't say, you know, fuck everywhere.
Yeah,
but expect a lot of more incredible collaborations with incredible people and a lot more new music, a lot more shows coming to you, and more merch. That's all of my announcements.
Yep. Well, see you guys soon.
On that note, thank you for watching. And thank you, John. Thank you, Leah.
Thank
Fabulous.
You,
thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure.
Das svidaniya.